Hi guys, this is Chris from Recombu and we're here with the LG G5 and last year's LG G4 to see what the difference is. So, as you see, one of the major differences you'll spot straight off the bat is the fact that the LG G5 rocks an all-new metal unibody frame compared with last year's G4, which sports a variety of frames actually. So this is the nice leathery model, very sexy, but you can also get it in bog standard plastic and stuff as well. So, the metal frame, it feels really nice. Feels maybe a tiny touch heavier than the LG G4, but also fits nicer in the hand because it's a 5.3 incher now as opposed to a 5.5 incher. So it is noticeably, in terms of height and everything, it's about the same, as you can see there. And in terms of thickness, there's not a massive amount of difference either. But actually, in terms of how it fits in the hand, it feels really, really nice. So they're good. On the back, as you can see, as well as the all-metal frame, there's also been a bit of a change in terms of the power buttons and stuff. The volume buttons are no longer on the back next to the power button like they were on the G4. They're now on the side here. And also, instead of just a bog-standard power button, you now have a fingerprint sensor. So it still pushes in like a button to turn on the screen. But once you register your prints, you'll also be able to just like stick your thumb over it and it should have locked straight into the desktop, which is nice. So going into the desktop itself, you see we've got Android Marshmallow on the LG G5 compared with Android Lollipop on the G4, which of course should get an upgrade soon. So you've got all of Android's latest features on the G5. In terms of Android itself, it looks very, very similar to the G4's. You've still got full control over the brightness and all your little toggles in the notifications panel, so that's nice. You can also edit the notifications panel like you could before, so you could put in all of your favourite shortcuts and everything. There's a couple of other little changes going to the recent apps thing, for instance. You used to be able to do a little bit of multitasking quite easily in there, get a bit of that on the go. Get the dual window, and then you'd have a couple of apps on the go at once. Now we've got this handy little pin icon. Basically, if you tap that, it pins the recent app, so when you hit clear all, it doesn't disappear. So that's quite handy for all of your favourite apps, stuff like the browser, things that you use quite often. Make sure you don't get rid of it when you get rid of all the other stuff that you don't need. One of the other big differences is the camera on the back. So now instead of just the single 16 megapixel lens, you now have two lenses. You've got a 16 megapixel and you've also got a new wide angle lens. So we go into the camera app, you'll be able to see that this is your bog standard lens, and then we can also tap this little icon here and we've got a new funky wide angle lens. So that's quite handy if you shoot a landscape or you want to go into a group shot, something like that. So that's something that was missing on the LG G4. And the other massive difference, apart from the fact that this is our Snapdragon 820 processor, as opposed to a Snapdragon 808, so it should run nice and nipply. G4, we have had a bit of slowdown over the sort of past couple of months, just purely because it's starting to get a bit bogged down with crapware and stuff, to be honest. The G5 now also has support for modular LG accessories. So you can slip the battery in and out nice and easily, like you could do on the G4. So there's no massive difference there. You could just prise off the back of the old G4, get straight into the battery there, if you actually have fingernails and like me. The G5, it's now modular. Okay, so you could just pop it open, slip the battery out, stick a new one in. You can also add in extra modules from LG. So for instance, they've got a cam module, where you actually get full manual controls over your camera, and it also includes an extra little secondary battery to keep you going for longer. And you can also add in, for instance, a hi-fi module, which gives you better sound quality from the phone itself. So those are some of the differences between the LG G5 and the G4. Something looks like an awesome phone. Looking forward to giving it a full play around. So if you've got any questions whatsoever about the G5 and the G4, let us know in the comments below. And thanks for watching, guys. We'll be doing more comparisons. Cheers.